already the civilian population of at least one great city has felt its effect. Naples, a city wrecked by the retreating Germans. Winter supplies of coal had been burnt, reservoirs had been dynamited. The gas, electricity and water supplies were blown up and destroyed. The Neapolitans were living amid the devastation and filth bequeathed them by the Nazis. Lack of food meant weaker resistance. Conditions were ideal for the spread of lice and an epidemic of typhus fever. They were without light, without heating, and almost the only water they could get was from the sewer. The typhus epidemic started. It started, as epidemics do, in a small way. Isolated cases began to come into the hospitals of Naples. But by October 1943, some 25 cases a day were being admitted. By the end of November, the daily admission rate had risen to 40, and the death rate was rising too. The situation caused grave concern to those responsible for the health of our troops in the Naples area. The increase continued by leaps and bounds during December, and it was anticipated that before the epidemic could be controlled, there would be 250,000 deaths, dead from typhus, dead from lice. One out of every three struck down by typhus will die. In January 1944, DDT was brought to Naples by the American Typhus Commission in the hope that it would save the situation. The population of Naples flocked to the 43 delousing stations that had been set up in the city, and there they were treated with DDT powder by some of their own fellow countrymen. Those who could not come to the dusting centers were treated in their homes. By the end of January, well over 1,000,000 Neapolitans, from the oldest to the youngest, had been disinfected. By the middle of February, the emergency was over. Typhus was on the way. And for the first time in medical history, an epidemic of this disease had been effectively checked.